Sail on 69th Street to document some of the fish kill that happened recently. As you can see, here are hundreds of little small fish, a lot of box fish and puffer fish that have died. I'm not sure when. Oh, there's a baby flounder. Looks like a baby flounder.
Kevin Boswell, I'm an associate professor here at FIU in the Institute of Environment and also in the Biological Sciences program. I'm also the program director of the Marine Biology program here at FIU. Our research is focused primarily on fisheries ecology, and we use a variety of advanced technologies for surveying them. So they include autonomous vessels and principally acoustics, but we also use other sampling technologies. What we're developing here within the Institute is an initiative based on the development of autonomous platforms for improving our sensing abilities in Biscayne Bay. And this largely came out of the effects from last summer during the fish kill, where we realized that we need to have the ability to broadly distribute survey effort, and using autonomous platforms was an efficient way to do that. So it allows us to understand how water chemistry changes, how animals respond, and also measuring and quantifying changes over time in habitat character, current structure. Through the Institute, we've developed this effort, which is called the Interdisciplinary Initiative for Autonomous Systems and Environmental Research. And the goal is to leverage the ability to use remote technologies and the benefits that are achieved through autonomous platforms, be they boats, be they buoys or aerial systems, so that we can quickly and efficiently sample or survey the environment to understand how things are changing and attempt to provide guidance on ways to respond. It's a really unique area that's linking many habitats and also many organisms. Not only do we have fish and birds that people are interested in and have an affinity for, but we have marine mammals. Manatees, we have dolphins that come through, and then it's actually a pretty decent place to fish too, right? And so, you know, the local users or stakeholders that appreciate these resources.
My name is Gregory Murad Reese. I'm an assistant teaching professor at the Knight Foundation School of Computer and Information Sciences. I'm also a researcher at the Institute of Environment. This all started for me in August 2020, last year, when we had the massive fish kill. We were very good at reacting to the event that happened in August, but now we should be able to predict when they might occur. What we're doing right now is trying to predict when levels of oxygen will go deep, so we can predict. It can serve as an alarm system to warn the authorities of possible problems that can happen in Biscayne Bay here in South Florida. So we collect the data, we analyze the data, and based on this data, we build models to predict when a certain parameter will go down.
Thank you.
modify our survey plan if needed, or even suggest additional sampling.
What I'm studying is the application of algorithms to improve the utility of autonomous robotics in environmental science and ecological science. A lot of these tools require a lot of technical knowledge and training, and that's difficult to transfer to ecologists, environmentalists, and other people of other disciplines. My hope is that by using more advanced autonomous capability, that more data can get collected, more work can be done, and with less effort and less cost.
We know that there's a lot of areas of research in Biscayne Bay that remain unresolved, and things that we really need to spend some initial focus on.
And I hate to say it, but sometimes good things come from bad things, right? And having the fish kill front and center and having our ability to respond to that not only allowed us to internally understand, well, what are our capabilities, what are our limitations, then address the problems that actually exist. There's things that we probably still don't know. It's not just us. I mean, we have all of these community partners. You know, we've got the municipalities, we've got the local government, and even the state government is now aware of the problems. And it's been really nice to see this become a thrust of interest within the state.
On the weekends, there are a lot of people on kayaks, and they always stop us and say, what are you guys doing? Where are you guys from? I think success will come from the citizens when everyone is involved.
You know, we continue to seek creative solutions, right? And,
you know, we're going to continue to run into problems. And so just the more effort we spend being creative, the better our chances of finding viable solutions.